Told his appeal had failed, Gregory said, "I'm finished. I'm a dead man." His only avenue left, an appeal to the parole board to change the sentence to life imprisonment, a course his lawyer intends to pursue. The Malaysian Supreme Court judge was not moved by arguments that Gregory had acted only under duress. But his life and that of his wife and child, seen here in the year after his arrest, were in danger if he didn't comply. The couple have since divorced. Gregory, described in court as mentally subnormal, was a small-time courier in one of the biggest drug syndicates uncovered by British Customs, involving the smuggling of heroin concealed in corsets and handed over in airport transit lounges. Its mastermind, former car salesman Paul Dye, is now serving a 28-year jail sentence in London, a contrast Gregory's local MP finds hard to accept.
He was not a person who really knew what he was doing in the same sense as those who organised him. There are people who made millions out of this sort of traffic and who sent him, a small man who needed a few pounds, off to Malaysia, not caring what happened to him or those who were affected by the drugs. It's the people like Paul Dye who are in prison in Britain, who will be out within 10 years. They're the ones who really ought to be in Malaysia suffering this penalty.
The Foreign Office here say that any question of them appealing on humanitarian grounds for clemency will be left until all the legal processes in Malaysia are exhausted. Only one remains, an appeal to the parole board in Penang to commute the death sentence into one of life imprisonment. But the precedents do not look good. British-born Australian Kevin Barlow went through a similar process 3 years ago. He was eventually hanged.
Now back in jail, all Derek Gregory can do is wait and hope. John Andrew, Thames News.